Leaders of the Trade Union Congress are expected to meet with state councils in Lagos on Wednesday and Thursday to review the minimum wage compliance in the states. On Tuesday, the Nigeria Labour Congress met for several hours in Abuja, where they analysed the reports of the minimum wage compliance. The new wage structure was signed into law by the President Muhammadu Buhari on April 18, 2019, while both the federal government and organised labour agreed on consequential adjustments on October 18, 2019, after negotiations. After the agreement between the federal government and labor, negotiations shifted to states, with the NLC directing its state leaders to commence negotiations with their governors. Now, the body said negotiations must be completed on December the 31st, 2019. And with me in the studio is a legal practitioner, Benard Onigan, to talk more about the minimum wage. Now, what do you make of all of this going on between the government and the state, the NLC, on this minimum wage matter?
Yeah, it's normal. Negotiations are normal in such circumstances. It's okay for the governors to say or to state reasons why they cannot pay at this time or at a certain time. Mm-hmm. And it's okay for labor to dig into those reasons. And they all have a conversation. It all begins and ends at the negotiating table, you know. And so I want to believe the consequential adjustments being spoken about basically as regards the fact that the minimum wage is a law, is a bill. It was deliberated upon at the National Assembly, mm-hmm. passed into law, and being assented to by Mr. President, went through all of the formalities of lawmaking, and so it is law. So it ought to take effect immediately. It is assented to, rather, by Mr. President. And so most likely some states did not budget for that increment. Mm-hmm. Some states are not ready for it. There are various reasons, and I can understand with the states, you know. However, Labour said, whatsoever it is, negotiations, consequential adjustments, whatsoever, what it is you're talking about, 31st of December 2019, all of these things should have been sorted and settled, and then most likely from January 1st we should have a smooth ride. But unfortunately, it doesn't seem to be so.
Because that brings me to my second question, which is, you know, they've gone past the deadline, and like you said, today is already the 9th of January. Does this seem that, is this an indication that, you know, we're not sure whether the governors are really serious about this negotiation, or is it something else?
Well, the governors, they don't really have a choice in this matter. Mm-hmm. You know, like I said, it was deliberated upon, it was agreed upon. And so the earlier they can only delay, but they are going to definitely adhere to the minimum wage law. I hear that some states have not even set up committees to even commence the negotiation. It's very bad of those states, you know. And it's actually the implementation is very poor, I must say. Only about six states have gone ahead with implementation at this point in time. You know, it's poor and it's not satisfactory, and I do not think it's good enough for the average Nigerian worker. They deserve that wage, and it's not even enough, you know. They're barely managing, mm-hmm. you know, so I don't see any reason why they should delay any further.
All right, so we've seen that the NLC also, instead of a showdown, there seem to be more rooms, you know, they're given opportunity to say, let's see what happens. Let's see if they are going to, the federal government or the states, rather, are going to move to the direction that we're expecting that they do. What's your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I commend NLC. I think they've been very mature. I give it to them, you know. They've been very understanding. And that's what negotiation is all about. It's mm-hmm. not about fighting, going on the streets. It's about having conversations over and over again and getting the other party to see reasons why. But of course, at this point in time, I hope they are not pushed to the wall. But I want to believe that their attitude, their posture, and the disposition of the NLC is highly commendable in terms of the negotiations. And I think it's a long time coming. The state governors should do the needful so that mm-hmm. it doesn't escalate beyond this.
Right. So we've seen also that some state governors, there's been the arguments of saying, yes, you say it's 30, but we're going to do what we are able to do. So which implies by that statement that maybe some state governors may not be able, you know, to pay the 30, the amount that has been set aside, has been mentioned already. Now, that's tilting towards saying there's lack of funds. Is that justifiable? I mean, are they justified, the governors themselves, who want to go that line?
You see, there are various economic indices that looked into before a minimum wage is arrived at. You look at all of this, you know, economics, the economists will tell you better, you know. And I'm, you know, the proposal was not even for 30,000. It was negotiated to 30,000. And so there's nobody, no state governor has an excuse of lack of funds, except that. So what I'll say to an average state governor in Nigeria is to direct funds in this direction. There's
make
money,
sure.
Yeah, there's funds. Take off the security votes, which we don't know what is being done with. How can you have a state, a governor gets as much as 30, 50 million naira a month that is unaccounted for? That still not made sense to some of us. And then the same governor tells he doesn't have enough money to pay. It is just that the people, the average Nigerian citizen bears the brunt and bears the burden of governance in Nigeria. They have enough money. They fly private jets every day. They should minimize it and pay workers their due.
All right, so as a legal practitioner, would there be any implication, are there legal implication in the event that maybe some governors of some states refuse or are not even able to pay this minimum wage?
There is no refusal here. There is nobody who is talking, who has a right to refuse, because it is the law.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly, and the government encourages private citizens to respect and obey the law. So I'm beginning to wonder why we need to begin to beg the government.
Even imagine.
Yeah, imagine over and over again to respect the law, especially when it comes to minimum wage and to pay. You know, strike actions and all of that, they are all legal actions. NLC has a lot of options. They do know that. But like I said, I give it to them for their maturity, you know. So, and of course, no government wants to be shut down.
Mm.
You know, somebody has to open the governor's office for him to go in. And so even the governor will be held to ransom, you know, in quotes, if they do not pay. So government activities will be held to ransom. Government will not be able to make money. And so it puts the state governments in much more precarious situations than I'm sure they do not want to get into, you know. So it's simple. They should go about, look at their budgets and take money where it is from and pay, because they have what it takes to pay, except that it is not just priority to them.
Mm-hmm. So indeed, the best bet will be to sort it out.
Of course, like I said, I give it to NLC, and of course, they know what to do very well. They are experienced. The labor leaders are quite experienced. They know what to do. But I hope that it doesn't get to that, you know, especially when they have shown much maturity, you know.
All right. Thank you so very much, Benard, for sharing your thoughts there.